Set, are you ready to go? That sounds a little bit better. Okay. So let's put on some bluegrass and think about it. I'll read you a romance novel too. I think about what all your friends are saying. It's only love that's waiting here for you. It's only love that's waiting here for you. What's up, everybody?
This is the front of where we started to illegally do things. Just unassuming side street, old section of downtown Greenville. And right here is, it's kind of like where we held shop for a while, as long as we can get away with it. Turned into a computer store after us. I don't know how they got rid of all the tags on the wall, but yep, that's the old Spazzatorium. Spent many a night there. The original name came from the house that I started with, which was basically a small living room that we threw mattresses up. That, you know, my bed, basically, I'd throw it up and soundproof using that, you know, buy a keg and invite people over to see bands. But there was at some point, bands wanted a name for the house because they were touring through, and I never really had a name. And one of them just listed the Spazzatorium as the name. It stuck, and since that show, everyone picked up on that name, and then, you know, so the Spazzatorium. And then Spazz. Spazz is like the shortened version. You know, that's kind of how things got started with that name.
Spazz Fest is the biggest event at Tipsy Teapot every year. This year is Spazz Fest IV. And Jeff Blender started this whole thing years ago. He just wanted to keep music in Greenville going, and he has been able to do that. And over the years, more bars have gotten involved and more musicians have become interested in playing, and it's just blown up. This year, it's 4 days straight of just music. During the day, at night, there's a breakfast on Sunday, more music Sunday night. Just crazy, crazy busy, and people just have a great time, and there's money to be made for everybody. And Tipsy is exposed to people, and people are exposed to the arts, be it music or the art that's on the walls or whatever else that goes along with Spazz Fest. Awesome Spazz Fest.
Greenville's local music scene is really important to have because of the fact that we have a lot of really talented musicians over here. Both going at ECU and not at ECU, if you look around, most of the musicians over here don't get enough exposure and don't have too many places to play that are willing to let them play. So supporting it in any way possible is the best thing that we could do for musicians to be able to excel and move on to the next step, which is touring and getting the music out to the broader audience.
What is Besetzt? For people that weren't here 10, 15 years ago, it was the premier bar and music venue in Greenville. You had a lot of bands that went on to become really popular come through. Fish played there, Dave Matthews played there.
Humphreys
McGee, Keller Williams, Lotus, a bunch of guys. And all these bands, you could just, you know, hop down there and see for $5. this is a really cool place, man, really chill, everybody was relaxed. You didn't have a, like a typical bar scene of, you know, just everybody's just laid back. And so that's what we were trying to bring back with this place.
Spazz Fest history is mostly with me. I've run sound last year for Spazz Fest at the Tipsy Teapot. I helped Jeff out with doing that, and I saw how great the event was. And so when we opened this here, Jeff asked if we could be a venue for Spazz Fest. I was, of course, I was like, that was going to be, you know, it's a no-brainer. And then, that is part of, you know, what Spazz is trying to do and has been trying to do for years is what we're trying to do as well.
Exactly.
You know, keep live original music going in Greenville and help build the scene back up to what it used to be, if not better.
Concur. You already
know. This is the door of entry for the band. You know, you could still see some signs of the old days, some tags. I'm curious to see if they ever got everything in there all wiped away, but I haven't been able to get in there since. It was crazy because a cop drives by, I still get the same feeling. Like I used to when I used to run it. They come by all the time, they have a substation there. But the fact that you know, we operated it kind of under the radar, you know, legally for this time, but still every 5 minutes a cop drives by. It's crazy that we were able to do what we did for so long. But yeah, rarely were we over capacity, but some of the shows, if Future Islands did play here, Proto Men played and it was way over capacity. The inside, you can see from videos, from old footage, there's a catwalk that goes above the stage area and actually behind the stage, and you could actually sit up there. So, you know, if it was over capacity on the floor, you wanted a good vantage point, you can actually go up and sit kind of above where the musicians are playing. Your feet would hang down, you could just look down between your legs and see people rocking out. People seem to like that. Generally, you know, it was a struggle to get people to come out, still. And and when they did come out, it was getting money from them. It was never overwhelming money-wise, and you know, majority of the time it came out of pocket, and that's okay. Rent wasn't too much. I can't remember the exact numbers, but our goal was just to pay our rent off, not make money. That was our plan, was to exist and exist as long as we could. Their history behind this place wasn't just me. There was other people who found it, other people who kept it going. I get a lot of credit for it, but you know, some of the early kids, they did their thing and made it a possibility to exist. So they have to get their credit, and you know, I'm only here just saying hi to it. But the spirit now, we have it roaming, hence the Spazz Fest that you'll be documenting. So the spirit that was in these walls when we couldn't have these anymore, for a certain place, we just let it rove, and now, you know, where we can find those walls to contain it, or if we don't have walls, we'll do a parking lot at Christie's, something like that, you know.
One, two, three. We are Matt Phillips and the Philharmonic. Wow, we suck at that. All right.
We are Matt Phillips and the Philharmonic.
Yeah, that one.
Yeah.
Okay.
Three, two, one. Hi.
We are Matt Phillips and the Philharmonic.
One, two.
Basically, a brief history of the band is I got to school at ECU in fall of 2011, and I met Greg, and we played with a couple other musicians in the School of Music, and me and Greg were the only ones who played together consistently. Then we met Travis, and then Trey, and then Connor, and as of January 2012, we were a cemented band as Matt Phillips and the Philharmonic, and we have played a lot in Greenville, and we're just starting to play all over North Carolina. A couple shows out of state here and there. And we're hopefully coming out with our first national tour this summer. We're gonna be hopefully all the way out to California and back. And we're also making our first record in a couple weeks. In our experience of Spazz Fest, we have been loved and supported by people that we would have never ever reached, and we have just really built a network with people who are, you know, down with what Spazz is trying to do, which is just make music more available. And I think in Greenville especially, Spazz is just the one time a year where people feel like they can just be themselves, you know, musically. And I think that working with a venue like Tipsy that is just so open to whatever type of music or whatever type of event, it's really worthwhile to come out to shows. And a lot of people by 19 or 20 haven't really gotten into the kind of local scene in a way that makes them want to come out and check out a show every night. But if they know that, you know, there's always something good going on at the Tipsy or always something good going on at Peasants or whatever, then, you know, people might be more likely to come out. And so far, people know that Spazz is a place where there's going to be a lot of different types of music and they're going to find something new that they haven't heard before.
I have faith. I think the fact that this town is kind of a void, it lends to like the weirdness factor, and people get really creative to fill their time. The art school here, I guess. People get bored and start doing creative things. Huge bands have sort of come out of Greenville. Like, I mean, the Avett Brothers, even. If you ask them straight up, you know, they would probably claim Greenville as part of their training ground. Like Valiant Thor and Future Islands. Greenville music has balls. People aren't afraid to, like, just do different things because, you know, with Jeff and everybody still doing these festivals, it keeps people inspired.
My name is Justin Flythe. Grew up about an hour north of here and followed a high school girlfriend to ECU, not really knowing what to expect from this place. And when I got here, I actually was reunited with a friend of mine from Governor School from when I was in high school, who's Sam Herring, who's from Future Islands. His band was playing Art Lord. So I went to this house show, and after that I was pretty sold. I'd never seen anything like that, you know, like coming from the country, growing up on a farm, going to a house show was kind of like a dream. That was the thing I think that set this music scene apart, was that it wasn't so totally contrived, you know, it wasn't about like rock star moves, it was more about having something to say. Jeff Blender, that he started the Spazz, and we were all kind of there for the inception of the Spazz. I feel like we all grew up together, you know, like musically, as guys, as friends. We all kind of helped make it happen, and now we're sort of doing different things, but we're all like still helping each other out, you know. It's definitely still a community. It's a bigger community really now, geographically and everything, but there's like a camaraderie there. And so now, elsewhere in the world, when you see one of those guys, it's kind of like, you know, you tip your hat to each other, you know, and help each other out.
Well, Spazz Fest 1 basically came together because it was the week right after South by Southwest, which is in Austin, Texas. A flurry of these East Coast bands would be going back to New York City or Baltimore or Philly. And all of a sudden, this one weekend, I would notice all these really amazing bands that I would love to have come through, wanted to come through on the same weekend. It was like a Friday and Saturday night, and it was like five bands per night, and, you know, one solid local and then four touring bands. That was awesome. And I said, we should do this every year. I'll plan it around South by Southwest, and, you know, all these bands that I would normally have to lure out and, you know, try to give a ton of money for, they're all trying to come through at the same time, so it's going to work. Now, that next year when I was planning it, the community found out that one of our own, Justin Flythe, he was in Lonnie Walker at the time. He actually, he came down with cancer. You know, everyone was trying to figure out how we could help in any way. And I said, well, why don't we combine things and make Spazz Fest a benefit, add locals who are willing to play, you know, to give their money over to helping someone from the community.
Justin's role with Spazz, he probably started in 2006. Spazz used to be, it's now the name that's kind of derived from the Spazzatorium Galleria, which was an actual venue that Jeff and Justin kind of set up. Yeah, when Justin was diagnosed with cancer, It limited a lot of things he can do he wasn't actually able to play out live a lot. He kind of stopped playing with Lonnie Walker at that point. He still wanted to be involved, but couldn't. Spazz that year, when he was sick, making this huge show was a way to give back. A bunch of musicians in a community giving back to someone that was like locally grown and was successful in his own right, and everyone knew and everyone liked, and it was just a way of saying thanks and, you know, we got your back.
It was pretty surreal, you know. I was a touring musician and just young guy, and I felt really invincible. And I was having a blast, you know. I didn't want it to stop, and it felt really unfair, and I just had to pray for the best, you know. Then when I found out what people were doing, it gave me so much hope. And it told me just how much good there is in a community.
A lot of people collaborated on it. Like, it became like this huge team of people. The kicker, though, was Justin got to play as Spazz Fest. Lonnie Walker played, and he got to play, and it was just a really awesome experience. Like, the mood, like, couldn't have been, like, better than it was. And it was honestly probably, hands down, like, the best couple days, like, of my life, honestly. I can say that without a doubt. Just the energy level and just how good everybody felt.
It kind of feels like a dream when I think back on it, to think, you know, so many bands came together and donated their time, and so many people, so many volunteers. Then, aside from that, the people that put it together, the people that made it possible, Todd and Jeff, they really were a team. They were like my cheerleaders. The community and them being able to move together as this huge force with this incredible inertia of positive energy. You can help so many people with that. They helped me. If there's a business or a person in need, I think we've all learned how to help one another, you know, using that.
That event culminated and happened, and it was amazing, because not only was it people having a good time, it was having a good time with a good cause. And with that combination, I said, well, that's something I want to continue to do if we do this every year. Pretty much every year after that, I decided that I wanted to give back to something that was in the community, be it a person or an establishment that allows creativity to happen or is creating something themselves. So yeah, the two was really the catalyst where I was like, well, Greenville could see that they can have a good time, but they can also support something.
Tonight is going to be an amazing night. Yeah, it's going to be Spazz Fest, the first night of Spazz Fest, which is going to be really awesome. We have a bunch of good bands playing. It's going to be taking place here and over at Peasants Pub tonight. Basically, Spazz Fest is happening, and it's going down. We're thinking we're going to have probably at least like 150 people over here, and then Peasants is probably going to have maybe like, you know, 130. But those are the confirmed guests who are going to be coming, and that's way more than we expected. I'm pumped, but I know that I'm going to have a lot of work to do. I'm going to be playing and running the show at the same time, and I'm going to be in and out doing all this other crazy stuff. So it's going to be a good night, and I'm excited for people to come out and see what we have to offer to the Greenville music scene.
These are the golden tickets. Willy Wonka style. Basically says you get into everything and you get some bonus stuff, and that bonus stuff is a free brunch, like I mentioned earlier. Also a free poster that's limited and special, and a couple other things. Drink specials. just does, shows your support of the Spazz to the highest degree, and because of that, we reward you pretty well. I'm demonstrating how it's going to work tonight for John, who's helping. Hey, I have a golden ticket.
What is your name?
Jeff Blinder.
Can you please write that on the back here?
Oh, okay. Should I sign it or?
Just print it, please.
Oh, Jeff. All right, do I keep this?
No, I'm going to keep it.
Okay.
You can pick it up at the Sunday brunch.
Ooh. The Sunday brunch is a free brunch happening at Tipsy that is awesome. And if you have that ticket and that wristband, you're good. Golden. Freebies. It's always intense when the line is lined up and they're like, I want to go see that band. And John's like, bleh, bleh.
Spazz Fest, you are awesome. Jeff Blinder. I'm going to go ahead and make that first shout out to you.
Come here, buddy.
How you doing, man? And thank you, Jeff Blinder. And everyone else, honestly. But my name is Matt Recko. I play piano, obviously, and sing. But here we go.
Exactly how many years it's been running, but hopefully plenty more. Thank you, America, and this is Spazz Fest.
Give it up for my good friends in Soft Talk.
Places like these, they allow all these other local artists to pretty much come by and like show what they got, and people here, they love it.
It's just got a lot of culture and stuff, you know, surrounding it, and it's a good place for people from, like, you know, all walks of life to come together.
This year is my first year here. So far, it's pretty tight, man. I don't know, it's my first time at Tipsy Teapot, too, so I don't know. Both bands have just played, killed it. So far, it started off great.
Personally, it's just more so the local music. I like local music over the radio stuff because, you know, this is kind of where they're starting. So yeah, I saw those guys when they're local. It has its kind of own style. Each band doesn't follow a unique pattern. It has its own way.
We need beer, apparently. Can you do that?
It doesn't matter what generation we're talking about, what gap we're talking about here. You have to realize from this understanding that the music scene will always keep going no matter what, because it's replenished by the kids who come here, the kids who believe in music and the kids who keep things going. And because there are people who do become dedicated to the scene that's in this area. And the greatest thing about the Spazzatorium is it finally may have a face to that scene for once, and it may have an identity. This is what we've come to call indie rock, more than ever as important in American culture. It's extremely, extremely important, and I think the Spazz has done that, you know. Valiant Thor started out here in Greenville. Now they're on two video games. Now they're on the Warped Tour. Same thing with Future Islands. Every album they've come out with, after a while, it's been in Rolling Stone. It's been in Spin. It's been all over. They're recognized. And, you know, they started here. But they started doing shows that nobody came to. And nobody really thought anything about them. So, you know, nobody thought to book them because they didn't think that they'd really make anything. You have to think ahead. You have to be a visionary. You have to think about what's going to happen years from now. It's extremely important to point out the Spazz and the effect it has had on the city. There is still a crowd that loves to come out and hear music, so it'll never go away. It'll never go away, and the best music that's happening is literally right now. It's happening tonight. It's happening in there, and, you know, we get to be a part of it, and that's kind of what makes the Spazz so important.
I'm looking to play to a stoked crowd.
Woo, woo, woo.
I mean, I feel like people are here to see good music, and I'm really enjoying this granola, so I mean, tonight is good. I mean, people are out, like, people know that this is where they should be, you know, tonight at least. I mean, I think this is the first time that we've had a lot of these people come out. I mean, people have known that this is going to be one of the bigger ones, and they want to be part of that. Last weekend we were rehearsing, and we played Move, you know, one of our funkier songs, for like an hour. Like, straight, like, over and over and over again with a metronome, just grinding that tempo into our brains. And so, like, playing it once is like, all right, cool, let's do another one. Woo! Woo! Hit me again. Woo! I mean, tonight so far, I see people that don't usually come out. All the people I was expecting to see are here, and then, you know, either because they're in other bands and they like to be out in the scene, or they're in bands that are playing tonight, or even people who are just here for the music. I mean, people have really turned out tonight, and I think it's going to be a really fun set.
Get coffee.
Thank you so much for coming to Spazz Fest. It's going to be here all weekend. Come out tomorrow. Come out the next day after that. And come out for brunch. It's going to be awesome. Thanks.
It was very fun. Everybody was good. It was a great success. I mean, everybody came here to have fun, and everybody did, as far as I could tell. So.
Been awesome just because we've seen so many old friends, rad bands, and I think just bringing people together from the old community, from the new community, and kind of keeping the spirit alive. We were a little bit more far removed from the Greenville scene as it was years ago when we were part of it, but I think showing the younger community what happened here, or what we were able to do and come out of, and I don't know, just bringing people together is a really important thing. And I mean, Jeff is a trooper in all things that he does. He's a pretty amazing person. And this is just another like little gift that he drops on Greenville. Knowing that you know, anything starts from the ground up. So you just like make it fun. Just do it because, you know, if you're not doing it because you love it, then don't do it. And if you want to do it, just make it happen. Make it happen for yourself, and all that other stuff will come later. Like we just wanted to make music for our friends and have a fun party. That's why we booked a show. It was actually supposed to be more of a spectacle than a show, and that was our first show, Valentine's Day 2003. And so much sprang out of that. You know, now with Future Islands, we've been able to travel the world. And that's kind of crazy. But it all started here just from having a good time and doing something because it seemed like the right thing to do. I definitely hope that there's some kids that come and just start making music in Greenville again and bringing that scene back. And I think it's continuing. So hopefully there's some like young kids who come in next year and are like, what's going on here, man? We should start a band. Me and William talk about that all the time. Just like we were, you know, that's the way we were, 18-year-old kids. Greenville is a unique place. I will say that in a lot of different ways. But there's always been an amazing community of people that are some of the most generous people in the world. And we're really lucky to be a part of that. I've always considered our backbone here. Like we, you know, cut our teeth in this city and we gained our first support here, and that gave us the strength to go out into the world and do all kinds of other things. But yeah, no, there is a group of people who that push really hard for music and make it happen in this city, even from far away. the way Jeff is able to still be a part of this community while living in Philadelphia is an amazing thing, and shows that kind of that spirit and loyalty that doesn't really die. which I think is really special.
Y'all are fun, man. Thank y'all. All right, let's do it.
Seemed like it went okay.
Yeah.
Just had an amazing time last night. This guy pulled it off.
These guys came through. We had a good team up, and that's what Greenville got the benefit, right?
About the shows and everything, the Spazz Fest was a success this time, and I'm really happy about it. And nothing went wrong, everything went very well. I'm glad that a lot of people came out, which was really great for us, and we all had a really great time, and I'm probably going to be hibernating for about a week.
Some kid goes to shows because he wants to look at a girl, or maybe he goes to a show because he wants to know more about how other people do what they do, because he's a musician himself, like aspiring. Maybe because you're just a huge fan. I mean, there's all different sides, and that's the most important thing, is like supporting local music, because if you don't, then it goes away. But I think it's like something like this that shows people what this is all about and kind of fosters that new hope and inspires. Like, that's the hope, is to inspire a new generation of people to come out and do it again.
Hey guys, I did want to say thank you so much for being part of Spazz Fest this year. This is not a one-person endeavor. I've been getting thanked all night, but this is a big machine. And I want to thank Laura Reimer and Dennis Kay and Caitlin Hassey and all the people who have been part of this for 10 years now. I've been doing independent booking. So this is a culmination, and I love it, and it's going to happen next year. And thank you to Peasants Pub and Tipsy Teapot and everything. That's all I want to say is thank you, guys.
Hey!
Oh, wow.